Do you want to learn how to store data that can be accessed with multiple different programs, or even keep the data even when you turn off and on your robot? Well, today I'm going to show you how to do that using Python file handling. G'day everyone, my name is Gary and welcome to another episode of Python for Spike Prime. Now today we're going to do something special. We're going to save data using a program through the Python file handling system. And then what we're going to do is use a separate program to read that data. And the cool thing about this is that the data will also persist even after you have turned off your robot. And this can be really useful in something like FLL if you wanted to go to a map and then store your light reflection values and then have it accessible through your other programs. Okay, it's going to be really, really mind-blowing. I've spent a lot of time on this solution, so please, if you haven't already, like and subscribe to my channel if these videos are really helping you out. Okay, so let's demonstrate how this works. All right, so like I said, this is a Spike Prime project. We have built the driving base 3, and all we have done is we've flipped the color sensor up. So if you've seen my last lesson, you'll know what to expect here. We're going to scan some colors using these two boxes, red and blue. And this is the idea, okay? So one of the programs are going to store 3 colors, okay? But then a separate program is going to play those 3 colors and have the status light here flash those colors based on what was scanned, okay? So let's have a look at this. So we'll go red, blue, blue, okay? So red, blue, blue, I'll go to a separate program. And then watch this status light. Red, blue, blue. Okay? All right, let's try it again just to show that it wasn't just pre-programmed. Blue, blue, red. Okay, blue, blue, red. Okay? Super cool. How did I do it? Well, if you have done any of our Python lessons before, you'll notice that there's a lot of capability in Python that isn't translated over into the block codes, okay? And what we're doing is we are using program 0 to write the colors that we scan into the file system onto the Spike Prime Hub. And then in the separate program, we are going to look for that file and then read it out again, and then play those colors that were stored in there. Okay, so let's go into the software and have a look at this. Okay, so here are the two files, okay? The first file is file writer. Now, if you look over here, you'll see that we are doing nothing special, okay? First, we define our wheels is equal to a motor pair, C and D. And then the color sensor is going to be equal to color sensor at E. But this is where it starts to get interesting. So F equals open, color file dot text, comma W. So what this does is it creates a new file called color file dot txt in the file system in the hub. Okay, so we have to make sure we remember that we call this file color file, okay? And then what's the second argument? The second argument, W, means that we are in a writing mode, okay? So W stands for writing, which means that we are going to start editing this file from the beginning. There are a few different modes out there, but for the purposes of this lesson, we only have to worry about writing and reading. Okay, so when we create F, we are opening a new file called colorfile.txt, and then we are writing to it. Then after that, we are creating a list, a blank list. Okay, and this is actually a bit of leftover code from when we were doing the color scanning code in the last lesson. And then here we're showing the happy face on the light matrix so that we know that the program is running. And now we're going to do a while loop. So while the length of the list is less than 3, then we are going to repeat everything in here, which means that we are going to scan 3 colors, basically. Because after each time we scan a color, we're going to put it into this list. We only care about 2 different colors though. So if the color is red or if the color is blue, okay? So if colorSensor.getColor equals red, then we write in the file system R, okay? Just the single character R. And then we append color onto our list. Okay, this is, like I said, it's going to be useful in case you needed to use it for another part of your program. And then we make a beep sound. If it was blue, we write the letter B, and then we append the color onto the list as well. Okay, and like I said, this is only going to scan 3 times because after the list reaches 3 items long, then it will break out of this loop and stop scanning. Now let's have a look at the file reader. So file writer is set at program 0. File reader is going to be set at program 1. And what we do is instead of writing, we are doing another file, but we are opening it in read mode. So we go F equals open, colorFile.txt R. So the R stands for read. And then the red string, we keep it as a blank string. Okay, show the happy face again to make sure that our code is working. And then we set the read string to file f.read, open and close bracket. So f.read basically means to read all the contents of the color file, okay, because we set f as the color file. And then for I in range 0 to 3, so we're looping through the 3 characters in our read string. If there is an R in the read string, then what we're doing is we'll turn the status light to red. But if it is B in the read string, we'll turn the status light to blue. Then we'll wait for half a second, turn off the light, and then wait for a half a second again to continue the loop. And that's it. Super simple. I hope you really enjoyed this lesson, and please like and subscribe to the channel if it helped you out. I'll see you again next time. Bye bye.